Hello, and welcome to the Michael Mazey production of Please Stand By. I'm really excited that you decided to come out today and see it. I think it's going to be a funny one. So, you're allowed to have one laugh. I'm letting you do that. But see this thing up here? It's a laugh counter. It counts every time. If you do it more than once, then I have to take your computer and replace it with this. This is a beach ball. It's not as good as a computer, so be careful. I got this thing. This thing's pretty cool. Whatever you're thinking about just kind of pops up on there. So, you know, when you just like got a thought in the brain, just kind of poof, right up there. And, what is this? What am I doing? Is any of this real? I mean, come on. Like, seriously. Look me in the eyes. Come on. Is any of it real? So I'm gonna go. I'm gonna let you guys have a good time, have one laugh, and enjoy Carroll Theater Department's production of Please Stand By.
What are we doing here?
Show yourself, sister. I know you're here.
Peyton, you're back already.
Hey, sisters. Did you miss me?
I did. Everyone else is so boring.
I take offense to that.
The Christmas tree is a nice touch. Being reunited when we first challenged each other. So predictable.
Yet only half as predictable as you.
So I assume you saw this coming.
And I assume you saw this coming.
Yeah, and I assume we both saw this coming.
Oh, not again.
Enough with the charade. Clearly those are empty confetti cannons.
Except for the ones pointed at Cameron.
What? Ah!
So, I assume you saw that coming.
Indeed. That's why I brought some balloons to go along with the confetti.
Yeah, well, I brought something useful. Food.
I know. That's why I brought plates and utensils.
Well, did you predict I'd bake a cake?
That's actually really nice of you. Wait, why are you doing this?
To prove how smart I am. That's what I do in everything.
Well, you're not clever enough to have predicted these balloons.
Well, did you foresee me buying this centerpiece?
Utterly predictable. Unlike this pepperoni pizza.
And I brought this to go along with it.
Impressive. But I'm afraid you've made one grave error.
Oh, really? Your confidence amuses me, Jordan.
You forgot to invite our family. And today's the big Christmas dinner, so I did it myself.
Good game.
Did you and Peyton just plan our Christmas dinner? Oh, fantastic. I did not see that coming.
Pretty good. Pretty good. You could use a little more marinating, but pretty good. No, it's fine. Sorry, Mary. I gotta take this.
I wish he loved me as much as he loves his secretary.
Mom, these sweaters are itchy. Can I take mine off?
No, be quiet. Grandma made us these sweaters, and I promised her that we'd send her a picture of all of us in them.
Can't we just take the pictures and change? I think I'm getting a rash from this thing.
You will wear that sweater for the rest of dinner, and you will not complain about it, or so help me God.
Oh, the tree looks great this year, Mom, and I love what you did with it. Gosh, are those new ornaments. I just love them.
Shut up.
No, they're the same as last year. Tilly, honey, maybe you should watch how much you're eating. You're starting to get kind of puffy. Remember, boys don't like fat girls.
Mom, I'm pregnant, remember?
Hey, what happened to the last one?
Last one? What does that mean?
This cranberry sauce is delicious, Mom. Did you use any?
We will be talking about this later, young lady.
Hey, Pete, when'd you get your ear pierced?
After I dropped out of college, remember?
When did you drop out of college?
Hey, stupid, you didn't drop out, you flunked.
Hey, what?
Hey, the pierced ear looks good on you, son. Might have to get one of my own.
Oh, I'm sure Violet would love that.
Yeah, I'm sure she would. Where can I go about getting one of those?
I mean, if you really want one, come to the same place I got my tattoo done. See?
Does that say evil?
Actually, it's pronounced evil. Evil backwards is life. That's deep. Aren't you supposed to be the smart one or something?
That reminds me. Mom, Dad, did I ever mention that I got valedictorian honors this semester?
You look good tonight, honey. Have you lost weight?
Yeah, I have, actually.
Trying to look good for that hippie boyfriend of yours, I guess. I hope you're making good choices.
You all right there, Pete? If you're choking, I'm trained in CPR and the Heimlich.
What did Violet need on Christmas, anyways? Shouldn't she be spending time with her husband?
Violet and her husband are actually, getting a divorce.
I don't blame him. I don't know why he married a woman like Violet.
Violet is a good woman. Oh, this is important. I have to take this.
George, if you don't come back here right now...
Sorry, Mary. I really have to go.
You know, I heard somewhere that every time a phone rings, an angel gets his wings. Mom, would you please pass the bread?
Bread? You want bread, Zuzu? Go get your own darn bread. You expect me to help you? I do everything for all of you. Nobody cares about me. I am your mother. It is Christmas, and the least thing that you could do is get the freaking bread by yourself.
Happiest time of the year. More like crappiest time of the year, right?
Should I door?
It's open.
What is she doing here? This is unacceptable. It is our family Christmas dinner. She cannot be here. Get out.
Honey, calm down. I can explain. As I'm sure you've noticed, Violet and I have been spending a lot of time together. But it's not what you think. She's been helping me make you this. Open it.
George is just amazing. I wish I had a husband like him.
What is this?
What is it, Mom?
Your father made me a scrapbook.
I bet you feel silly now.
Yeah, I bet you wish you hadn't screamed at him all night.
My scrapbooking skills are subpar, so I needed Violet's help. I just wanted to surprise you with something nice, since you do so much for all of us. It's got pictures of our wedding, the kids' baby pictures, pictures from last year's vacation, all our old family photos. I really hope you like it, honey.
Oh, George, you are so sweet. Your wife is so lucky to have you. She better watch out before somebody snatches you right up.
I'm so sorry, honey. I've been so rude to you all night. Things have just been crazy, and Zuzu was driving me mad, and...
What? Me?
No need to apologize, sweetheart. Zuzu, stop bothering your mother.
I'm sorry, but what? I still don't understand. All night, these two have been acting insane, and I've been doing my best to mediate. What the...
You two are so sweet.
Oh, Violet, I forgot you were still here. You can go home now if you'd like.
Are you sure? I would love to stay for dinner. It smells so good.
Take the hint.
No, Violet, I appreciate your help with the scrapbook, but please go home.
Fine.
You guys see her? She was totally checking me out.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
Spell what?
Hanukkah.
H-A-N-A-K-K-A.
Thank you. Spell Hanukkah, go.
Oh, God, no. I'm the world's worst. Ask my students right down there. I cannot spell.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
I don't know. H-O-N.
How do you spell Hanukkah?
H-A-N-U-K-K-A-H.
Now, the gifts will come through on this conveyor belt. Then they will continue on into the next room where the other elves will pack them and put them into the sleigh. Now your job is to take each gift, package them, put a bow on them, and put them back on the conveyor belt. Understood?
Yes, sir. Ma'am. Yes, yes, ma'am. Ma'am.
Here we go. Alrighty then. Letter roll. Letter roll. Looks like some elf fell asleep on the job again. Jingles Peppermint Smith, if you fall asleep one more time, you'll be polishing the sleigh until next winter.
Wow, someone's in trouble.
Yeah, what are you doing over here? I thought you were organizing gifts next door.
Yeah. They kicked me out of there fast.
Why?
I kept opening the gifts to see what they were.
I mean, I haven't done too well either. I was doing actually a pretty good job feeding the reindeer. Until Rudolph had some broccoli.
Okay, then. Ready to start? If one gift goes out of this room unpackaged, you'll both be set down as elves on the shelves.
Yes, Mrs. Claus.
Yes, Mrs. Claus.
Let her roll.
Hey, this is easy.
Yeah, I think I could handle this all day.
Oh no.
Listen, I
definitely think we're playing a losing game.
I can't get the bag open.
Uh-oh. Do you see that?
See what?
There's plenty of stuffed animals coming.
Oh, jingles.
Oh no. You know what? Let's just start wrapping. And hope for the best. You wrap
the- How's it going in there, elves?
Is she coming?
Just take them off, take them off. We'll wrap them in a second.
We get in trouble?
Do you want to become an elf on the shelf?
No, I really don't. Take
them off. Hide it. I think she's coming.
Hi, elves. You're doing splendidly. Speed it up, Jingles!
Hold up, what? No.
She's speeding it up?
Yeah! Can you not feel it? Just, like, tap whatever you can.
This is too much.
Too much. I'm so done. You know what? Just let them through. I just want to go back to feeding reindeer.
Hi, I'm Burke Tanyel from KDGN. I want to thank you all so much for taking the time out of your night to watch Please Stand By. It means so much to us here at Carroll Theater. We can't wait for you to see what's coming next, so please sit back, relax, and give a warm welcome to Carroll Jazz Band. I'm Burke Tanyel from KDGN, signing off.
I cannot wait for Christmas.
Me too. I am so excited for you to get your gift to be Pacific. See what I did there?
Please do not discuss presents before I open them this year. I want them to be a surprise.
Hey, calm down. You haven't seen them yet. Don't mean to toot my own horn, but you'll love them.
Stop spoiling it, Dad.
Relax. He just said you'll love it, and I agree. You have good presents.
Please, just stop talking. Not you too, Mom.
Whoa there. Why are you being so paranoid? We haven't given anything away.
Oh, great. Now I know everything.
Watch your tone. There's no way you could have learned anything from what we just said.
Oh, really? Dad hasn't had anything good to say about my presents since my birthday last year when he got me a book of dad jokes as a gift.
Oh, yeah, I do remember that. It was pretty funny.
This shows he has a preference for cringy, outdated, and practical jokes. This means that he must have gone to a prank store and bought me something stupid. So when he said not to toot my own horn, it means he must have gotten me a fart cushion as a present.
You're right.
Mom had said that she loved the presents, and Mom has a history of liking coloring and the ocean. On top of that, Mom said to be Pacific, which is a really bad ocean pun. Which means she must have gone to Barnes & Noble's to get me a coloring book about the ocean with coloring pencils to go with it.
Well, holy heckin' ranch dressing, you make Sherlock Holmes look dumb.
I'm not finished. Mom had said nothing has been given away yet, but then she looked down at her feet, which clearly means she got me the electronic I've wanted for 5 months now. At first, I thought it was an iPhone, but then she blinked twice, so clearly it's an iPad.
Wow. I was the one who went shopping, but you know more than I do.
Thankfully, I do not know what the last present is.
Let's keep it that way.
Oh, great. Now I know everything.
I got new tennis shoes.
Wrong! It's flip-flops. Oh, wait, I should not have said that.
Okay. It's okay. I'm still grateful for you guys.
Oh.
Okay, I've got my popcorn. Let's see what's on Hallmark. Ooh, Hallmark in under 5 minutes. Yes, please. Hot chocolate Christmas. That sounds good.
Hey, you should come to this Christmas party. We can meet some really cute guys.
One, you know I've hated Christmas ever since incident on Christmas Eve 3 years ago. Two, you know I have to plan Adam's stupid Christmas gala.
One, I think you work too much. I know you're the CEO of the company, but you need to take a break. Two, you know I really think you should find another man.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Here, let me help you.
Yay! The meet cute!
No, it's fine, I got it.
Oh, okay.
Speaking of finding yourself a new man...
What? No.
I saw the way you looked at him.
Okay, Savannah, no, I am engaged, remember?
Anyways, you have to think of something for the gala.
I know, I can't think of anything. Oh, you know what? I actually gotta go. Bye. Oh, hey, it's you again.
Oh, hey, sorry again about the mess I made yesterday.
Oh, no, it's really okay.
I don't suppose I could buy you hot chocolate to make up for it.
I actually really like that.
So what's gotten you so stressed?
Oh, I'm just planning this Christmas gala.
Oh, could I help at all? I love that kind of stuff.
Oh, no, you don't have to.
I know I don't have to. I want to.
Well, okay, I guess there's a few things I could let you help with.
So what's the theme of this Christmas gala anyway?
Winter Wonderland.
Wow, how original.
Ignoring that comment, we need to start working. What was that? What the heck are you doing?
Beer it. Something.
Yeah, what's up?
What? I wanted to tell you that I'm the son of Kris Kringle.
The son of Santa Claus?
Yeah, I hope that doesn't change anything.
No.
OMG! I did not see that coming at all.
Oh, I'm sorry. I really have to take this.
Wow, Noelle, you really outdid yourself.
Thanks. I had a little bit of help. Oh, there he is now.
Oh, hey, I've been looking for you.
Who's this?
Adam, this is my, friend, Ben. He helped me plan this whole thing.
I just gave a little inspiration.
I don't think I'm okay with you hanging out with other guys.
It's not up to you, Adam. I can be friends with whoever I want.
I just don't want you seeing that guy anymore.
Why are you being so controlling? I thought we went over this. I thought we talked about this.
What's going on over here?
Fine. If I'm so controlling, then I guess we're over.
Fine!
Noelle! Noelle, slow down.
I can't believe I ever loved that guy.
Slow down. Are you sure this relationship can't be fixed?
Any feelings I had for him are long gone. Besides, I think I might be falling in love with someone else.
And who would that lucky someone else be?
You.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
M-O-N-I-C-A.
Monica?
Hanukkah.
Oh,
H-A-N-U-K-K-A-H.
H-A-N-U-K-K-A-H.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
H-A-N-U-K-K-A.
Thank you. Spell Hanukkah, go.
H-A-N-U-K-K-A-H.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we know a place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally say goodnight,
I will hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight,
all the way home I'll be warm.
The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
He doesn't care if the sun be low. He's sitting by the fire's cozy glow. He don't care about the cold and the winds that blow. He just says, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Ooh-wee, goes the storm. Why should he worry when he's nice and warm? He's got by his side and the lights turn low. He just says, let it snow, let it snow.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go,
let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought lots of corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Finally say goodnight.
I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight,
all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Christmas is almost upon us, and tonight, with a very special treat, debuting their own holiday songs, is one of my favorite musical duos, Nora and Michael.
Hey!
Hi! Ooh. Thanks.
Is everything okay, guys?
No, we forgot we were coming over here.
We knew, we just thought it was next week.
Oh, are you guys not ready, or we can...
Oh.
We are ready.
Yeah, all ready to go.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Well, I'm really excited about these songs. I heard you guys have been working on them for months.
Yes.
Yes. We're so prepared.
Sing, you know.
Okay, well, that's great. Let's hear it.
Candy canes are
red
and white.
And striped.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. Was that even the song? Do you guys know the words?
We were kidding. We're kidding.
This is a comedy show, right? Come on, you know the song.
Yeah. Let's sing the song about the stockings, the Christmas stockings.
King.
And the trees.
Trees. Yeah, I love that one. That one's great.
Are you ready?
Christmas. Stockings.
And trees.
Are
made.
For
rocking
around. I didn't mean to interrupt. Sorry, guys.
You didn't.
That was the end.
Oh, that was the end of the song?
Yeah,
that was the end.
When I talked was the end of the song.
Yes.
Yeah, that was it.
You perfectly timed it.
Oh. It was the end of the middle of the sentence was the end of the song.
Yes.
That was it.
All right. You know, look, guys, I just think maybe we could bring you guys back when you're ready. I just don't think that...
Come on, Mana. Serious. We want to get our songs out there. Our music.
We spent a very long time writing and arranging these songs.
Our gifted singers. You understand that?
Come on, this is our chance. Music producers are watching this.
Mana, please. I've never asked you for anything, ma'am.
This is the first time I've ever met you.
Please, we drove all the way from Keller.
Okay, all right. Well, then in the spirit of Christmas, let's do it.
Actually, you know what? This one is for real.
This is real. Hit it. Dashing
through the snow.
This is pretty.
One horse open sleigh.
All
the
round the
Christmas
and the
sleigh. Yay.
Thank you very much.
I'd now like to welcome our very special guest, the Carroll Choir.
Tree tops glisten.
Kids, I have a surprise for you. Elf on the Shelf. Dollar Tree, Elf on the Shelf, but nonetheless, still Elf on the Shelf.
What's that, Mom?
Well, every day, the Elf on the Shelf will take notes on if you're good or bad, then a night report back to Santa.
Hey, I'm not sure I like this idea.
Oh, it'll be fun. I'll put him on the mantle for now. Have fun, kids!
So, you want to play a game or something?
No, I want to play with Mommy's makeup.
That's for girls, though.
You're a girl!
Wait. He's got a pen and paper. Why do we keep looking away?
I don't know. He could be anywhere, waiting, watching us for to slip up, and then bam, no more presents. I'm only 8. I can't handle this level of stress.
Just calm down. Just calm down. We're going to find this elf, and when we do, we're going to...
Oh my gosh! He's gathering evidence!
He's gone! We have to find him! Charlotte, go check Grandma's weird ancient flowers. I'm gonna go check the fireplace.
Okay.
Where are you, evil elf?
Where? I see him. Quick, give me some rope and a tiny chair.
What are you gonna do?
Whatever we have to do, get off. Ow, ow. Oh, he bit me. Where did he go?
He's gone again.
He escaped using his evil witch magic.
Our only hope is to get him out of the house. He can't hurt us if he's outside.
You're right. Hey, be careful. He looks like he would go for the eyes.
There he is!
I got him! Be gone from this house, you tiny elf demon!
Whew! Are we safe?
Yeah. Yeah, I think we're safe.
He's on your back!
What? Kill him!
What is going on?
We've had a hard day.
Why on earth would you wreck our house like this? You both are... in trouble? Liam, get the rope and tiny chair.
Well, it's that time of year again. Time for Christmas cards and letters, some with a family update. I got one from some friends of mine, Stanley and Elaine Pritchard, who live in upstate New York with their two kids. I don't know them all that well, but their family photo and letter just seemed so perfect. I'll read a little bit for you here. Season's greetings from the Pritchards. It's so wonderful to have our whole family together again for the holidays.
Come on, gather around the tree. Snap the picture. Let's go. Dad, can you get this over with? Smile. It's gonna be on our holiday card. Let's go.
This sweater is itchy.
Gee, your grandma knitted it herself.
What does that have to do with anything?
Use itchy yarn. Just gather around the.
Okay. Oh. Ah,
right, get the.
Hope you like our annual picture in front of the fireplace. We haven't put the tree up yet. We've just been so busy. Stephanie graduated culinary school and is now working in one of New York's most popular restaurants.
Okay, that's a number 6 of the die code. Would you like to supersize it for 59 cents more?
I said no onions, okay? Make sure there's no onions.
Okay, that's fine.
Stephanie loves preparing food for appreciative customers. In the meantime, Stanley and I celebrated our 25th wedding anniversary this year. 25 means silver, and Stanley surprised me with a small token of his affection.
Hey, look, I found an old quarter.
Oh, yeah.
Happy anniversary, sweetheart.
Oh, yeah. Happy anniversary.
Hey, if it's soft, it could be silver. Why don't you bite it and see?
Why don't you bite it and see?
Stanley's career took an unexpected turn. His boss surprised him with a lot of vacation time. We treasure our time alone together, and after all these years, we're still discovering new facets of our relationship.
Stanley, are you gonna get out of your pajamas and go looking for work today?
Yeah, hold on, I'm concentrating. I'm about to make us a lot of money online.
That's a poker site! I hate my life.
Daniel completed his first semester at college, where he's making a lot of new friends.
Come on, you little wimp. Danny, come on.
I am. Shut up. Just give me a second.
Freddy, you gotta put the rotten eggs in the dean's desk. Just do it. Come on.
I'll do it. Wait. Someone's coming.
What is it, dude? Hey, what are you kids doing in my office?
Oh, it's the dean. Run for it, man.
And what are you doing?
The window's stuck!
We'll break it, let's go!
Hey, I saw you, Pritchard. You're on my list, Pritchard. You're on my list, Pritchard.
Daniel made the dean's list. We're just so proud of him. Our cup runneth over. We wish you peace and prosperity this holiday season and throughout the coming year. Write and tell us about your family. We hope you're as happy and blessed as we are. Love always, the Pritchards.
All right, reindeers and mooses, the best of the best are here. And Connor. Anyways, it is Christmas Eve and I am ready to fly.
Woo! Go Christmas!
Woo!
Yay!
Woo! Hey, yeah, let's do this! Hey, why is Rudolph cheering?
Well, you know, I guess I just thought I have a chance on being on the team this year.
Keep dreaming, neon nose!
Right, and the last thing we need up in the sky is a stoplight.
Or a glowing cherry.
Ho, ho, ho. All right, everyone. Settle down. Settle down. I just looked at the weather report, and I'm sorry, but it's too cloudy to fly. Christmas is canceled.
Oh, wait, what? Come on. Why do they can't? Oh,
what? What? No Christmas? No, that's not fair.
Christmas is ruined. What are we going to do?
No.
Bright and shiny nose, you can guide us.
Wait! You mean it, Santa?
Of course I do. I'm assigning you lead reindeer. Everyone, let's hear it for Rudolph. Christmas is saved.
Woo!
Yes, Rudolph! Woo!
Woo! Go, Rudolph!
Gee, thanks, Santa. I won't let you down.
Zip it, Comet. Santa hates you.
Harsh?
I don't know what just happened, but congrats.
Oh, you can put that away, Donna. Or whatever your name is.
Rudolph?
Oh, it's Rudolph now? I thought it was Neon Nose. Classic. What's up, Blitzen?
Hi.
What you call my nose? A stoplight? Oh, I like that, making fun of someone else's way of crippling self-esteem and anxiety. How original.
Hey!
It's true and you need to know it. Also, Connor!
Look at you making me so stressed my weave be falling off.
Oh no, Rudolph, we understand you're upset, but chill, let's be friends.
You with the cherry joke. How original, Donner's weird cousin. Why are you even here? You're not a reindeer, you're an elk.
I'm a moose.
Whatever, I'm still mad about you ripping off my weave, but all of you want to be friends with me. Because I'm flying tonight as lead reindeer. And you know what? I'm gonna eat a lot of broccoli!
Ew! Nasty.
Ugh, why would you do that to yourself? Ew.
I actually kinda like the smell.
Oh, heck no. I'm telling Santa.
Oh yeah, mister, I'm telling Santa? Watch this. Santa! Dasher's making fun of me!
Oh, Dasher, are you making fun of poor, poor Rudolph? Shame on you.
I didn't do anything!
Rudolph, you are so, so strong. And Dasher, I'm keeping my eyes on you.
Crazy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, just calm down. I look forward to working together.
Ooh! Wait! You believe me and expect me to work with you?
Well, yeah.
We can change that, you know why?
Why?
Because I'm lead reindeer.
Reindeers, get ready!
Looks like Santa's calling. And when you see him, thank him for me.
Hi, I'm here with Coach Dodge. Coach Dodge, do you know how to spell Hanukkah?
Hanukkah? I do not.
Could you try for me, please?
Hanukkah. H-A-N-A.
Yeah.
N-A-A-K-A.
Yeah. Okay, and now, do you have any advice for college students struggling with virtual classes right now?
Try your best. I don't know.
Okay, thank you, Coach.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Spell Monica, go. No. Just spell Monica.
C-H-R-I-S-T.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
H-A-N-A-K-K-A.
I mean, I wipe everything down, I sit there, I don't eat while I'm there, just kind of stay in my own little bubble. There's an H in there somewhere. Spell Hanukkah, go. A spell? Yeah, Hanukkah. Hanukkah? Hanukkah. Yeah. H-O-M-I-C-A. Hanukkah, right? I don't know what it is either.
Kaliki Maka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Kaliki Maka is Hawaii's way to say Merry Christmas to you. Mele Kaliki Maka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Mele Kaliki Maka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas to you. The stars at night. Mele Kaliki Maka is Hawaii's way to say Merry Christmas to you. Mele Kaliki Maka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Mele Kaliki Maka is Hawaii's way to say Merry Christmas, a very Merry Christmas, a very, very, very Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.
Christmas time at Carroll, and everyone's doing fine. Everyone is happy, no schools vandalized. Can't wait to see my friends at school. Oh wait, you're all online. Hi. Christmas at Carroll. It's a Christmas carol.
Draw a Christmas tree in the air. Thank you. Draw a Christmas tree just in the air.
Oh, that's hard.
Okay.
Thank you.
Draw a Christmas tree.
Mr. Giamalco, can you draw a Christmas tree?
Like draw a Christmas tree?
Yeah, like just point your finger and draw a Christmas tree. Miss Miller, can you draw a Christmas tree?
Think about it.
If it's
like, yeah, Mr. Burton, draw a Christmas tree.
Okay.
Hey, stand up.
What?
Come on, stand up.
What am I doing?
Draw a Christmas tree.
Draw a Christmas? Like, in the air?
Yes.
There.
Daniela, draw a Christmas tree. Mr. Hazipta, draw a Christmas tree with your finger, like in the air.
Like this? What am I doing? Why do I feel like this is some kind of trick?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Hey, that's me.
So the reindeer's been mean to him because of a shiny, bright red nose.
You have a weird nose.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna be friends with you.
And they were playing and laughing, making the toy ready.
Let's all play a game without Rudolph. We should make the all the toys ready by himself. And they tell them to eat alone. You can't sit here, Rudolph.
You might have to. Go sit over there by yourself.
Rudolph is sad because they tell them to eat alone.
I'm so sad. Everyone's really mean.
So that froggy outside and the two rangers been sad.
It's too froggy. For me to see, I can't deliver presents. Christmas has candles.
No Christmas.
And Rudolph saved the day with his bright and shiny red nose.
I can help my nose can light the way.
Thank you, Rudolph.
Rudolph can lead my sleigh.
You saved Christmas. Everyone loved him.
We love Rudolph. Let's go deliver some presents.
So the reindeers delivered the presents to everyone. The end.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
Spell Monica?
Hanukkah.
Oh. Oh my gosh. H-A-U-N-A-C-U-K?
Okay, thank you.
Spell Hanukkah, go.
That's all.
Hanukkah. Spell Hanukkah.
H-A-N.
H-A-N.
I don't know the rest.
Okay.
You're not getting any
more. Spell Hanukkah, go.
I don't know off the top of my head, and that's bad.
Just try.
Hanukkah. H-A-U. I'll just go K-K-A. Okay. I'm literally Jewish.
You're going to need a half cup of softened butter.
One egg.
2 teaspoons of baking soda.
1 teaspoon ground ginger.
Next, you're going to need a half a teaspoon of salt.
You'll need half a cup of butter flavored shortening.
Add 1.5 cups of... sugar.
1 tablespoon of vanilla extract.
2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon.
3 tablespoons of molasses.
Half a teaspoon of ground cloves.
3 cups of all-purpose flour.
Stir the butter shortening and sugar together as well as the softened butter.
Add the egg, vanilla, and molasses and mix until well combined.
Now the flour, baking soda, cinnamon, ginger, ground cloves, and salt.
Mix all the ingredients until well combined, using a wooden spoon if needed.
Heat oven to
But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all! And to all, a good night." It's not how it happened at all. Who wrote this? Oh, hi! I didn't see you there. Good to see you, dragons. Oh, hey! By the way, I've been going over my naughty and nice list, and I do have to say, some of you... I'm just joking, except Miss Pringle. She needs to work on it a little bit. Now, anyway, I wanted to tell you how wonderful you have been this year. I know it has been hard on everyone, but you are hanging in there. And I'm sure all this craziness will be over by next Christmas. Oh, and by the way, let me tell you, on Christmas Eve, don't worry about me coming into your house. I have plenty of sanitizer. Oh, by the way, guess how much Santa's sleigh cost? Nothing. It was on the house. Oh, anyway, Merry Christmas. Now be good the rest of the year. I'll be watching.
Well, that's all, folks. We hope you'd enjoyed it. Thank you all for watching.
A special thanks to Carroll Choir, Dragon Band, Miss Joy, our wonderful directors, and of course, our technicians. Alex, Ross, Eden, Alika, Pierce, and Sam. Thanks, guys. We couldn't have done it without you.
And thank you to our wonderful cast.
Nora.
Katie.
Grace.
Sohani.
Hannah.
Burke.
Anna,
Mana,
Alexis,
Cole,
Louisa,
Michael,
Camilla,
Evelyn,
Riley,
and Anna Claire.
We had so much fun making this, and we hope it brought you some joy this holiday season. From us at Carroll Theater, happy holidays!
Happy holidays!
Happy holidays!